Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hopkinton High School for Hopkinton Hillers softball. Today, the 12-3 Hillers welcome in the 11-3 Westwood Wolverines. Westwood is led by head coach Jonas Scher, while the Hopkinton Hillers led by first-year head coach Kylie Murray. The Hillers have been on fire as of late. The offense has been coming through. The pitching from Bree Mirabli has been outstanding as they locked up a huge win last week against first place Norton in what was an absolute pitcher's fest between Bree Mirabli and Katie Nelson. Katie Nelson, the leading pitcher in the TVL, one of the top pitchers in the state, but the Hillers got the 1-0 victory after 10 innings and took the game. And since that, they also defeated Holliston. As we are set to go here from Hopkinton High School, stepping in for the Westwood Wolverines is Jamie Burke. And the Westwood Wolverines, they've been playing some very good softball this season as their strike one on Burke, and 0-1 count. Bree Mirabli, the pitcher, of course, for the Hopkinton Hillers, as this is hit in the air towards left field. Ranging under it to make the catch is Lindsay Whittles, and there is one away in the top of the first. Let's take a look at the Hopkinton Hillers field. Bree Mirabli, the pitcher, Kate Welzel behind the plate, Isabel Holden at first base, Emily Whalen, the second baseman, Molly Bennett at short, Emma Murphy at third base, left to right after this pitch. As there's a strike, 0-1 on Jenna Burke. Jenna Burke, the twin sister of Jamie Burke, who just flew out. Mirabli set to deal. There's strike two, 0-2. From left to right, Lindsay Whittles, Lily Morningstar, and Katie Hawley for the Hopkinton Hillers. Wind up and the pitch, just outside, 1-2. Let's take a look at the Westwood lineup. You had Jamie Burke fly out to start things off. Jenna Burke, her twin sister, at the plate now as that one's fouled away. Jamie Burke is the third baseman, the leadoff hitter. Jenna Burke, the shortstop. Courtney McHugh batting third. She's the catcher. Simone Nevels, the first baseman, in the cleanup spot. Dana Bamford, the pitcher, in the fifth spot. As this is a little bloop shot, Mirabli has it no problem. Two away in the inning. That'll bring up Courtney McHugh, the catcher. Batting sixth is the second baseman, Jordan Judd. Seventh, the right fielder, Shannon Rooney. Eighth, the center fielder, Monica Hatch. And ninth is Laurel Orcott, the left fielder. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call to bring you Hopkinton Hillers softball. 1-0 to Courtney McHugh. Mirabli set to deal. Hit in the air and out of play. 1-1. Bree Mirabli has gotten better and better as the season has gone on for the Hillers. That one outside, 2-1. Mirabli set to deal. And this is hit in the air, a fly ball over towards shallow left field, and it's grabbed by the shortstop, Molly Bennett, for the third out of the inning. They go down 1-2-3, and we will head to the bottom of the first. It's a scoreless game between the Westwood Wolverines and the Hopkinton Hillers. We are set for the bottom of the first, a scoreless game between the Westwood Wolverines and the Hopkinton Hillers. Let's take a look at the Hopkinton Hillers batting order. Leading things off, the center fielder, Lily Morningstar. Katie Hawley, the right fielder, will bat second. Molly Bennett will bat third. Kate Welzel will hit cleanup. She's the catcher today. Heather Hawley will bat fifth. She's the designated player. The windup and the pitch, the bunt, is going to be strike one. So Heather Hawley, the designated player, in the fifth spot. Lindsay Whittles, the left fielder, in the sixth spot. Bree Mirabli hitting seventh. She's pitching today as that bunt pulled back, 1-1. Isabel Holden, the first baseman, batting eighth. Emily Whalen, the second baseman, batting ninth. And of course, Emily Whalen had the game-winning hit in that classic pitcher's duel against Norton as Dana Bamford set to deliver once again to Lily Morningstar. The 1-1 pitch on the ground, third base side. Throw to first is not a problem as the first baseman, Simone Nevels, lays down the tag. A 5-3 ground out for Morningstar. Katie Holly will come up to the plate. Let's take a look at the Westwood Diamond. Dana Bamford, the pitcher. Courtney McHugh, the catcher. Simone Neville's at first base. Jordan Judd, the second baseman. Shortstop Jenna Burke. Third baseman, her sister Jamie Burke. Is that pitch outside? 1-0. From left to right, Laurels Orcutt, Monica Hatch, and Shannon Rooney for the Westwood Wolverines. That pitch upstairs. Dana Bamford's had a nice season on the mound for Westwood. That one's fouled away. Katie Holly set to step back in. A 2-1 count. Katie Holly, a freshman, getting some good experience this year. Is that one down low? 3-1. A 200 batting average. She's played in 8 of the games coming into this week. These stats not totally up to date. Wind up and the pitch. On the ground, foul, full count. As far as the pitcher Dana Bamford, she has pitched in 13 games this season. As this is a pop fly in the air, shallow left field, and it's going to drop in front of the shortstop and left fielder. So Katie Holly gets a break there, and she's aboard at first base with a single. That'll bring up Molly Bennett. Dana Bamford, a 2.99 ERA on the season, 10-3 overall on the mound. She has started all but one game. As there's strike one to Molly Bennett. 0-1. Molly Bennett at a 250 mark on the season coming into this week. That pitch upstairs, 1-1. Katie Holly aboard at first base. Bamford delivers, and the hitter was out of the box, not ready. Late timeout call. Count remains 1-1. Bamford set to deal. And this is a liner, and that's past the reach of the second baseman. That'll drop into center field. Holly approaching third. Bennett up to second, and everyone's safe. Molly Bennett with a double, and she really had to speed that one out. That had single written all over it. But she took that extra step after the center fielder hesitated on where to throw the ball, and she took second base just before the throw got in. And now catcher Kate Welzel steps in. Welzel at a 275 coming into this week. She tips that one away, 0-1. Welzel also has 3 home runs this season, 10 RBIs. Wind up and the pitch. And this is on the ground, third base side. That's going to get through into left field. One run around, a second run coming around. 2-0 Hillers. A 2 RBI single by Kate Welzel. And now Heather Holly will step in. Bamford delivers, that's fouled away, 0-1. Dana Bamford works quickly for the Westwood Wolverines. And she's a junior. Certainly towards the top 10 in pitching in the TVL. And this is a little grounder, bobbled by the second baseman, a flip to first, is not going to be in time. And another run did score as well. Welzel advanced to second. It's still 2-0, no run scored on that. An error on the second baseman. And that'll bring up Lindsay Whittles. So So 2-0, 2 on, no outs as the Westwood infield had a meeting of the minds in the pitcher's circle. As the left fielder steps in, she's at a 242 on the season, or coming into this week. Through 11 games, she was at a 242. As that pitch is down low, 1-0. That's a rough error by Judd to keep this rally going, really, for the Hillers. Welzel on second, Holly on first. Two runs already around to score, as that one's fouled away, off of a Kate Welzel 2-RBI single. Bamford delivers, there's a swinging strike. The lefty steps back in. And this is lined into center field. That'll drop down. A third run being waved around. Welzel is going to come around to score. An RBI single for Lindsay Whittles. And the Hillers racking it up in the first inning as Bree Mirabli will step in. Bamford delivers. There's strike 1-0-1. Heather Holly on second, Whittles on first. No outs still, three already in, or one out, excuse me. On the ground, third base side picked up, third base is tagged, there's the second out. So a force out there, a six unassisted force out will allow Mirabli to reach. Two outs. There's strike one. Oh and one. And that is right back to the pitcher. And the bench getting a good laugh at that one as the Hillers put up three runs to start things off in the first inning. We'll head to the top of the second. Hopkinton leading Westwood 3-0. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Westwood Nurseries, located at 93 East Main Street. Visit their garden centers in Hopkinton or Chelmsford, and you can discover limitless possibilities to create your own backyard paradise. You can find them online at westwoodnurseries.com. Top of the second, the Hillers leading Westwood 3-0. Simone Nevels will step in to face Bree Mirabli. Hillers went through eight hitters in the bottom of the first. As Nevels, the cleanup hitter for Westwood, steps in. Good hitter, 486. She's played in all 14 games and takes ball one there. 486 batting average. 19 runs scored, 15 RBIs. There's strike one, 1-1. Three doubles, five triples, and a homer. Right up and the pitch, upstairs. Set to deal, swinging strike. Neville steps back in. Just outside. Mirabli delivers. Swinging strike. There's out number one. First strikeout of the game for Mirabli. That'll bring up Dana Bamford, the pitcher. The junior is hitting well this season, has batted in all 14 games, 426 batting average. There's strike one. 10 runs scored, 13 RBIs, three doubles, a triple, and a homer. Mirabli deals. Swinging strike, 0-2. Mirabli set to deliver. And there's strike three, 1-2-3. Jordan Judd will now come up to the plate. Jordan Judd, a junior, also hitting very well for Westwood. And Westwood, they've hit well all season. That's going to make it a 1-0 count. As a team, they're batting a 371. And they have 135 runs scored. There's strike one, 1-1. The Hillers, in comparison, only have 67 runs scored. So the Westwood bats have been what has really powered them to that 11-3 record, as there's a swinging strike, 1-2. There it is. She strikes out the side, and it is going to be 3-0 Hillers as we head to the bottom of the second. The Hopkinton Hillers looking to keep the early offense going, as coming up this inning will be the 9-1 and 2 hitters. Emily Whalen will step in, followed by Lily Morningstar and Katie Hawley. As Whalen, the freshman lefty, steps into the box. Dana Bamford set to deliver. On the ground, 1-0. Emily Whalen has had a tremendous year, especially for a freshman. 306 batting average coming into this week, as there's a pop fly there. Third baseman makes the catch, one away. That will bring up Lily Morningstar. She grounded out in the first inning to start things off. Morningstar has also done very well with the bat, a 333 batting average coming into this week, as there's a strike. Coming into the week, she scored 14 runs, driven in 5, also has a home run to her credit. Bamford deals, and this is sliced into left field. That'll drop in for a base hit. So the speedster, Lily Morningstar, aboard with a single, and that'll bring up Katie Hawley. Katie Hawley singled, ended up scoring a run in the first inning. Bamford set to deal. And this takes a couple hops right back to Bamford. The throw to first will pull the first baseman off the bag, but she's able to fall right down on the bag before Hawley was able to get there. But Morningstar pushes up to second after a 1-3 ground out, and that'll bring up Molly Bennett. Molly Bennett hit a double in the first inning and scored a run. Bamford deals. Couple hops on the ground, third base side, throw to first, not a problem. And that is going to do it for the inning, a 5-3 ground out. And we will head to the top of the third, the Hillers leading Westwood 3-0. A cloudy day here at Hopkinton High School, temperatures in the high 60s, but so far so good for the Hillers, who lead the Westwood Wolverines 3-0. As we head into the top of the third, due up are the 7, 8, and 9 hitters for the Wolverines. Shannon Rooney, the right fielder, Monica Hatch, the center fielder, and Laurel Orcutt, the left fielder. As Rooney will step in. Shannon Rooney, a junior, a 237 batting average, 12 runs scored, 8 RBIs. Mirabli set to deal. The bunt pulled back, strike one. Mirabli delivers. Down low, 1-1. There's strike two, 1-2. Swinging strike, and there's out number one. Rabley with four strikeouts in this game. Coming into this week, had 116. That number is sure to go up. Busy week for the Hillers, a four-game week. As Monica Hatch steps in and takes ball one, 1-0. Rabley deals upstairs, 2-0. To the set. There's strike one, 2-1. Monica Hatch at a 273 batting average. There's strike two, 2-2. Nine runs scored, four RBIs. There's strike three. Five straight strikeouts for Bree Mirabli. That'll bring up Laurel Orcutt, the senior. She's at a 235 mark on the season with six runs scored and three RBIs. Down low, 1-0. Rabley delivers, 2-0. Wide up and the pitch, upstairs, 3-0. There's strike one, 3-1. Top of the order due up next if Orcutt reaches. Fouled away, full count. The decisive pitch, that's fouled away. Rabley deals, strike three. She ends up striking out the side. Despite starting off with a 3-0 count against Orcutt, she ends up getting her via the strikeout, and that is now six strikeouts for Bree Mirabli as we head to the bottom of the third with the Hillers leading Westwood 3-0. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate your pest problem, eliminate your pest problem. You can find them online at WPCPest.com. Bottom of the third, Hopkinton Hillers coming to the plate with a 3-0 advantage over Westwood as Kate Wilzell, the cleanup hitter, steps in. She had a 2-RBI single in the first inning. And she hits this one over to left field, but right under it to make the catch is Orcutt for the first out. That'll bring up Heather Holly. She reached on an error in the first inning. And she puts this one on the ground, a short throw to first is there. Two-way. Lindsay Whittles to the plate. So you see after a tough first inning, Bamford coming into her element a little bit. Swinging strike, 0-1. Bamford delivers. That is punched over to the third base side and then bobbled by Burke. So Whittles reaches, and I'm calling that one an error. Actually, that is, you are able to argue that's not an error. That was the most awkward bounce I think I have seen. It just kind of stopped in midair and fell straight down. As Mirabli crushes this one over to right field, and that is going to roll to the fence. Runner being waved around third. Mirabli is safe at second, and it's 4-0 Hillers as Whittles comes around. An RBI double for Bree Mirabli, showing some power there. Two outs, another run in. Isabel Holden up to the plate. Bamford deals, fouled away. 0-1. That one looked like for a second, if it stayed up just a little bit longer, would have cleared that fence. Bamford deals. On the ground, up the middle, throw to first, not a problem. Holden goes down 1-3, but not before the Hopkinton Hillers plate another run. And it is 4-0 as we head to the top of the fourth. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Fletcher Tilton, attorneys at law. You can visit them at FletcherTilton.com. Due up for the Westwood Wolverines, Jamie Burke, Jenna Burke, and Courtney McHugh, the top of the order, to face Bree Mirabli. Mirabli set to deal to Jamie Burke. She flew out her last time up in the first. There's strike one. 0-1. Jamie Burke hitting pretty well this season. Is that one outside? 1-1. 392 batting average for the senior. 15 runs scored, 13 RBIs. Hit in the air, a high fly ball towards left field, and that'll drop in front of the dive of Lindsay Whittles. So Jamie Burke is aboard with a leadoff single. And that will bring up Jenna Burke, her twin sister. Jenna Burke, a senior, and Jenna Burke at a 481 on the season. 26 hits this year. That one's upstairs. She actually has 99 career hits. If she gets a hit in this game, that'll be her 100th hit of her high school career. As this one is a fly ball towards the Hillers bench and out of play. 1-1. Rabley deals. And this is hit into center field. That'll drop down for a base hit. And congratulations to Jenna Burke. She has her 100th career hit. Well, her 100th high school career hit. And now you see the head coach for the Westwood Wolverines going out to talk to the umpire, Jonas Scher. And he's going to take that ball and put it aside. And that'll bring up Courtney McHugh. 100 high school career hits, certainly not easy to accomplish. Congratulations to Jenna Burke. As Courtney McHugh will step in. Two on, no outs. That one up high, 1-0. Well, as I mentioned earlier, Westwood, very good hitting team. Certainly have to watch these hitters, 1-1. Especially the top of the order. But that is, it's been offense that has powered Westwood to that 11-3 record. There's strike two, 1-2. Swinging strike, and there's out number one. Simone Nevels will come up to the plate. She struck out her last time up in the second. It's the seventh strikeout of the game for Mirabli. There's strike one on Nevels. Mirabli deals. There's strike two. Rabley to the set. Just inside, 1-2. Wind up and the pitch, fouled away. Count remains 1-2. Rabley delivers. Strike three. Two straight strikeouts in the inning. Dana Bamford will come up to the plate. She struck out as well in the second inning. Rabley deals. Fouled away, 0-1. Right up and the pitch, down low, 1-1. And that is going to get by Welzel and allow both runners to advance. Jamie Burke moves up to third, Jenna Burke up to second. Rabley deals, upstairs. Wide up and the pitch. Down low. Rabley to the set. Hit in the air, foul. Full count on Dana Bamford. Wide up and the pitch. Air strike three, she got her looking. And despite the two lead hitters reaching base, Rabley gets out of it unscathed. We'll head to the bottom of the fourth. Hillers leading Westwood 4-0. Bottom of the fourth inning, 9-1 and 2 due up for the Hillers. Emily Whalen, the second baseman. Lily Morningstar, the center fielder. And Katie Hawley, the right fielder. Hopkinton leading 4-0. Dana Bamford set to deliver. There's strike one. Nice movement on that pitch. Oh, and one. Just outside. One and one on Whalen. Down low, 2-1. Bamford deals. And this is sliced, and it'll be handled by the shortstop. A nice catch by Jenna Burke. One away. Lily Morningstar will come up to the plate. Bamford deals, the bunt pulled back. Bamford deals, that bunt pulled back as well. 2-0. Morningstar hit a single in the second as there's a swinging strike. Two and one. Bamford deals. Strike two. Bamford delivers, hit in the air, a high fly ball, and that'll drop just in time to land in right field for a base hit in front of Shannon Rooney. And it is another single for Lily Morningstar. Katie Hawley now up to the plate, one out, one on. Bamford deals. On the ground, first base side. That'll get by Neville's into right field. And Morningstar will stop at third. It is a single for Katie Holly. It's her second base hit of the game. And now Molly Bennett steps in. She had a double and scored a run in the first inning. As the top of the order for the Hillers today has been the thorn in Bamford's side. There's a strike. Runner taking off from first. Stolen base for Katie Holly, uncontested. 0-1 to Bennett. One out, two runners in scoring position. Bamford deals. Swinging strike, 0-2. And it got away from the catcher, McHugh, a little bit. Morningstar thought about going home, but McHugh quickly regathers. Bamford delivers. It was just outside, 1-2. Upstairs. 2-2. And this is punched into center field. That'll drop down, one run in. Second run being waved around. It was bobbled by the right fielder. Two more Hillers runs come around to score on the single by Molly Bennett. As Morningstar comes around and Katie Holly. It's now 6-0 Hillers. Kate Wilzell at the plate. That one upstairs, 1-0, throw over to first. Bennett slides back safely. Bamford delivers. On the ground, third base side. It's bobbled, picked up, throw to first in time. A 5-3 ground out for Wilzell, but Bennett pushes up to second. Two outs in the inning, Heather Holly to the plate. Bamford deals. This is on the ground, past the reach of the shortstop. A runner being waved around as it is bobbled over in left field. And Heather Holly is safely aboard over at second base. So Heather Holly with the two base hit gets the RBI as Bennett comes around to score. And now Lindsay Whittle steps in. Down low, 1-0. And this is on the ground, up the middle, gloved by the second baseman, throw to first, not a problem. A 4-3 ground out for Lindsay Whittles, but not before the Hopkinton Hillers plate three more runs as Morningstar Holly and Bennett all come around to score, and it is 7-0 as we head to the top of the fifth. HKM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Angels Garden Center, located at 65 School Street, growing in Hopkinton since 1957. You can find them online at angelsgardencenter.com. Westwood Wolverines coming up to bat, trailing 7-0. 6-7 and 8 hitters due up. Jordan Judd in there now, and that's going to be low for ball one. 1-0. Rabley has gotten all three outs via the strikeout in the last three innings. 1-1. She gave up two singles to start the fourth, but then struck out the next three hitters. Strike two, 1-2. Rabley deals. Just outside, 2-2. Swinging strike, as that was gloved by Wilzell, one away. I'll bring up Shannon Rooney. Hey, Lily. You're right. We're here. safety steps in. Fouled away. Right up in the pitch. Bunt up the middle, gloved at short. Throw to first! And it was just a little bit late as Rooney beat it out. Good coverage by Whalen as Isabel Holden held back in case there was an overthrow. And that was a good defensive play by the Hillers. Infielders in on the corners as Monica Hatch will take ball one. One on, one out for Westwood. There's strike one. Rabley deals, and this is in the air and foul. One and two. And this is a pop-up, and Emily Whalen will run over behind first base to make the catch. Two outs, one on. Laurel Orcott will come up to the plate, the right fielder. And she'll have a word with the head coach before she steps in. Jonas Schur. Hillers leading the Westwood Wolverines 7-0. For those of you just joining us, we're in the top of the fifth. Bob Hamilton on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. This is hit in the air, a pop-up third base side, and ranging in to make the catch is Emma Murphy for the third and final out of the inning. And we will head to the bottom of the fifth. The Hopkinton Hillers leading 7-0. Bottom of the fifth inning, a 7-0 lead for the Hillers. Two up in the batting order, the 7, 8, and 9 hitters as Bree Marabli will step in. She's 1-for-2 today. Grounded into a force out in the first inning and an RBI double in the third as this one's tattooed to center field. Another base hit for Marabli. Good piece of hitting there. And now Isabel Holden will step in, showing off the power today. We're going to have a pinch runner for Marabli. Katie Sylvester will come in. Bamford delivers, that one up high, 1-0. Bamford to the set, there's strike one, 1-1. One on, no outs here in the bottom of the fifth. And this is up the first base side, glove by the second baseman, throw to first, they get one, but Sylvester pushes up to second. Good job by Sylvester getting the head start. One away, Emily Whalen to the plate. There's a strike. Sylvester taking a big lead off of second. Always a threat to steal. Speedster. Bamford delivers. First base side up the line. Gloved by the second baseman. Throw to first, two away. Sylvester up to third now. Lily Morningstar will step in. Having a nice day. 2-for-3. Scored a run as well last inning. Fouled away, 0-1. Wind up in the pitch upstairs. One and one. I'll make it one and two. Two outs, runner on third for the Hillers. Hopkinton already up 7-0 in this one. As Morningstar will have a word with head coach Kylie Murray. Bamford set to deliver the 1-2 pitch. Just upstairs, 2-2. Bamford deals, fouled away. Bamford delivers the 2-2. That's down low, full count. Fouled away off the backstop. Turns the hitter away, Morningstar draws the walk. Katie Holly will now step in. The lefty 2-for-3 on the day, also scored a couple runs. Upstairs, runner takes off from first, stolen base for Lily Morningstar. Good job by Courtney McHugh, the catcher, holding onto it with Katie Sylvester at third. Wind up in the pitch, just outside. Bamford delivers. That one outside as well. To the set, and this is up the first base side. That'll get into right field, one run in. Second run being waved around, and it's 9-0 Hillers. A 2-RBI single for Katie Holly. Good job getting it done as head coach Jonas Schur will call in his whole team to the pitcher's circle to talk things over. Rabley, or Katie Sylvester and Morningstar around a score on that 2-RBI single by Katie Holly. It's her third hit of the game, 3-for-4 overall. You got Molly Bennett coming up next. Bennett also having a good day, 2-for-3. She had a double in the first, ended up scoring a run. Grounded out in the second and had a 2-RBI single in the fourth and scored a run. And we're going to get a new pitcher for the Westwood Wolverines as head coach Schur decided to take the ball from Bamford, and moving over from shortstop will be Jenna Burke. Dana Bamford will move to shortstop, so just a player for a player swap there. So new pitcher for the Westwood Wolverines, and she's going to take a little bit of time to get warmed up, so we'll take a quick timeout here on HCAM. Continuing on with the bottom of the fifth inning, a new pitcher for the Westwood Wolverines. Jenna Burke moves over from shortstop to pitch. And Dana Bamford now playing shortstop, and also a new second baseman, Emily Dukeman, now at second base. Wind up in the pitch. Jordan Judd out of the game as that one's fouled away. Runner took off from first. She'll have to go back. Also a new center fielder, Jamie Burke, to play center field. Is that one upstairs? She was the third baseman early on. And now over at third base is the catcher, Courtney McHugh. So that one's fouled away off the new catcher. Is Jenna Burke set to deal? And this is popped up in the air, foul. Just behind us, as the sun starts to peek out. I couldn't quite get a number on the catcher, but Westwood just moved players really all over the field. So that one upstairs. Catcher is Riley Jenkins, the junior. So she comes into the game. As this is punched into left field, that'll drop in for a base hit. A single for Molly Bennett. Katie Holly moves up to second. Starting pitcher Dana Bamford still responsible for Katie Holly. So Kate Wilzell will come up. Two outs, two on, two already in for the Hillers. A 9-0 lead in the bottom of the fifth. Jenna Burke deals. Outside, 1-0. Okay, well, Zell, 1-for-3 this game, had a 2-RBI single in the first inning, also scored a run. Swinging strike, 1-1. She'd love to drive in a couple more runs here. Burke delivers. Strike two, 1-2. Burke's at the deal. It's upstairs. Right up in the pitch, down low in the dirt. 2-2 is Jenna Burke's fifth appearance on the mound for Westwood. She's pitched 9 innings coming into this as this is popped up into center field. That'll drop in for a hit. Run being waved around. A throw home is in time. So that will be it as Katie Holly tagged out trying to come home. You can credit Kate Wilzell with the single. But that will do it for the fifth inning. The Hillers do add 2 more runs. It's 9-0 as we head to the top of the sixth. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Webster First Federal Credit Union, providing financial products with attentive customer service to the local families and businesses of Hopkinton. You can find them at WebsterFirst.com. Top of the order due up for the Westwood Wolverines as Jamie Burke will step in. Burke 1-for-2 today. A 9-0 advantage for the Hillers. As their strike 1-0-1. 2 more runs plated in the bottom of the fifth. Rabley deals. Upstairs, 1-1. And one upstairs as well, 2-1. Rabley deals. There's a strike, 2-2. And this is hit into center field. That'll drop down for a hit. A single for Jamie Burke. And now Jenna Burke will step in. Burke sisters, two very good hitters for Westwood. Jenna Burke had her 100th career high school hit in the fourth. Take strike one there. 0-1. Rabley deals. And this is popped up. Whalen has it, no problem. Little pop fly for the first out. Courtney McHugh will come up to the plate. One on, one out. McHugh moved over from catcher to third base. Runner taking off from first row to second is in time. Jamie Burke caught stealing. And that was a great throw from Kate Wellzell. Wellzell certainly a catcher you don't want to try to steal too much on. That one inside. And called a strike as it grabbed the corner. Two outs as Burke caught stealing. Rabley deals. That's hit in the air. Is it in playable territory? No. Rabley delivers just outside. Rabley deals, and that one up high. The decisive pitch fouled away. Count filled up. Rabley deals the full count pitch, and this is hit in the air to left field towards the fence. But there to make the catch with no problem is Lindsay Whittles. McHugh got a good piece of that one, but just not quite enough. And that will retire the top half of the sixth inning. We'll head to the bottom of the sixth. The Hillers leading Westwood 9-0. Bottom of the sixth inning, Hillers leading Westwood 9-0. Due up the 5, 6, and 7 hitters, Heather Hawley, Lindsay Whittles, and Bree Mirabli. To face Jenna Burke, who will work from the pitcher's circle for her second inning. And we are set to go. And we actually have a pinch hitter for the Hillers. That pitch is going to be ball one. Emma Murphy, the pitcher, the hitter. And she was originally the designated player. So there's a strike, 1-1. So the Hillers will lose that designated player role for the game. That's fouled away into the backstop, 1-2. Emma Murphy awaits the pitch. Just upstairs, 2-2. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike. It was on the ground, throw up the line is in time, one away. Murphy goes down via the strikeout. And we have another pinch hitter for Lindsay Whittles. It'll be Azalee Curl. So Azalee Curl into the game. umpire timeout there. Burke set the deal. That's slice foul, 0-1. Burke delivers, and this is hit in the air. That'll drop into right center. Aslia Curl aboard with a single. And Bree Mirabli will stay in the game to hit, at least. More than likely will stay in just to get the three outs in the seventh as well. That one up high gets by the catcher, and Curl is going to advance on the wild pitch. Burke delivers, and this is popped up in the air to right field and handled. That is going to be the second out of the inning. Curl stays put at second base. And we'll have another pinch hitter for the Hillers. This time it'll be Maddie Abbott stepping in, the junior for Isabel Holden. Two outs, one on. There's strike one, 0-1. Burke delivers to Abbott. Strike two, 0-2. Burke set the deal. Just outside, 1-2. Well, the Hillers have been on an absolute tear as of late. Started off the season 0-2 as that one was fouled away. Now at 12-3. Second in the TVL behind Norton. Wind up and the pitch, and this is on the ground up the middle, gloved at short. Throw to first, not a problem. A 6-3 ground out for Maddie Abbott, and we will head to the top half of the seventh. Hillers leading Westwood 9-0. The Wolverines are down to their final three outs. Oop. Top half of the seventh inning, Westwood down to their final three outs, and we're going to have a pinch hitter here for Simone Nevels, as the Hillers excited to get their 13th win of the season, just three outs away. And stepping in to pinch hit is Amelia McQuaid. She's a senior. And she takes strike one. Westwood, unless some crazy miracle happens, will have their fourth loss of the season. There's 0-2. Line up and the pitch, just outside, 1-2. There's strike three. One away. Yeah, one up. Oh. And we have a new first baseman for the Hillers as well. Most of the pinch hitters stay into the game as Dana Bamford takes strike one. There, that one fouled away. 0-2. Maddie Abbott over at first base for the Hillers. This one's popped up, and it is out of play. Rabley deals. That one just inside. Taking a look at the TVL standings. Norton on top at 14-1. The Hillers about to improve to 13-3. Westwood about to fall to 11-4. As this one up the middle, Mirabli picks it up. Throw over to Abbott, no problem. 1-3 ground out, two away. Millis at 10-6. Bellingham at 9-6. Then you got Medfield at 8-8. Holliston at 6-7. Ashland 4-11, Medway 2-13, Dover Sherbourne 1-15. There's a pinch hitter here for Westwood. Takes ball one. Stepping in is Emily Dukeman, a junior. Swinging strike, 1-1. There's another strike. Just blowing it by her, 0-2. There's strike three, and that will do it for the Hillers. What a pitching performance by Bree Mirabli. Dominated a very good Westwood lineup. And the Wolverines, they have a lot of good hitters on this team. There's a reason that they're 11-4. And it's because of offense, but today Mirabli was just on fire and they just could not touch anything. 11 strikeouts for Bree Mirabli. As the Hillers get their 13th win of the season. Hillers started things off early, putting up three runs in the first inning. Those three runs were scored from a two RBI single from Kate Welzel, which scored Katie Holly and Molly Bennett. Then an RBI single from Lindsay Whittles. Then the Hillers would add another run in the third. An RBI double from Bree Mirabli drove in Lindsay Whittles. Three more runs would come in the fourth. A two RBI single by Molly Bennett drove in Lily Morningstar and Katie Holly. And then Heather Holly drove in Molly Bennett with an RBI double. At that point, it was 7-0, and then the Hillers add two more in the fifth inning. As an RBI base hit by Katie Holly, or a two RBI base hit by Katie Holly, drove in Bree Mirabli and Lily Morningstar. The Hillers score 9 runs, and they do so on 17 hits, commit no errors, while Westwood scores no runs. They had 4 hits and 1 error. Your player of the game, it has to be Bree Mirabli, putting up 11 strikeouts against this potent Westwood lineup and leading the Hillers to yet another victory. And we'll also give away an offensive player of the game here. Molly Bennett, she went 3-for-4 today, scored 2 runs, had 2 RBIs with a 2 RBI base hit in the fourth inning. Once again, the Hopkinton Hillers defeat the Westwood Wolverines. The final score for the final time, Hopkinton 9, Westwood nothing. The Hillers 13-3 on the season. Westwood falls to 11-4. For Bob Hamilton on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for joining us for this presentation of HCAM Sports. This has been Hopkinton Hillers softball. Thanks for watching, everyone, and enjoy the rest of your day.